humanity. That was the title of the painting I was admiring, Allegory of Vanity. A number of years ago, my wife Pat and I went to the Kimball Art Museum for an exhibit called Caravaggio to Dali. I must confess that the Dali end of the exhibit only took me a few minutes to look over. But among the scores of stunning pieces of art from earlier centuries, there was an oil painting done about 1660 by Juan de Valdez Leal, and it really grabbed my attention. The title, Allegory of Vanity. In this painting, there is a profusion of objects which symbolize the vain and transitory nature of our earthly endeavors. A timepiece, money, cut flowers that are wilting, stacks of books, jewels, a king's crown and scepter. And right smack dab in the middle of the painting, that which had caught my eye to begin with, a bishop's mitre. A bishop's mitre. A symbol of ordained ministry, right in the middle of a painting titled Allegory of Vanity. I gotta tell you, it made me think. For many, many people over the centuries, being ordained was seen as a kind of recognition, an award, an honor, an achievement, an affirmation of one's accomplishment. Viewed like that, ordained ministry and its symbols are indeed a type of vanity, aren't they? But it simply isn't true. It isn't true. It may have been understood that way by many, many, and still may be today, but being ordained isn't an achievement, like graduating from college and receiving a diploma, or being recognized by one's peers with an award. It isn't. Lynne, you're not about to be elevated to the priesthood. The priesthood is not an upwardly mobile career. Just the opposite. It is just the opposite. The priesthood is a downwardly mobile calling. I want to say that again. The priesthood is a downwardly mobile calling, not an upwardly mobile career. And so tonight, then, we need to reflect on the true nature of what it means to be a priest in Christ's church. There's an old Roman Catholic understanding of the priesthood which goes like this, in Latin of course, Sacerdos, alter, Christus. Christus is Christ, alter is another, like alter ego. Sacerdos or sacerdos is priest, sacred. Sacerdos, alter, Christus means the priest is another Christ. Now, to those who think of priesthood as an affirmation of accomplishment, calling oneself another Christ seems only to heighten the vanity, doesn't it? And to many Protestants who hear Catholics say the priest is another Christ, they shake their heads and respond, yeah, sure. But if sacerdos alter Christus, if the priest is another Christ, then we need to look first to Christ the great high priest to see what it means for us as priests. For you, Lynne, soon to be ordained a priest, to be alter Christus. So if the priest is another Christ, we look first to Christ in the creche. What did our Lord have to do in order to become part of his creation, in order to become the Word made flesh? We heard it in tonight's epistle. Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men. And being found in human form, he humbled himself. Christ in the creche is God emptied. Christ in the creche is God impoverished. Christ in the creche is God humbled. So if the priest is an alter Christus, then the priest is one who is called to the life of Christ. The priest is called to a life of self-emptying and humility. That is not vanity. Second, if the priest is another Christ, we look to Christ on the cross. I can't think of a more fitting day to be ordained priest than today, the feast of the Holy Cross. Again, as we heard in tonight's epistle, Christ became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Christ on the cross is God the Son, obedient to the will of God the Father, offering his life in sacrifice for others. So, if the priest is an altar Christus, and the priest is one who is called to the life of Christ, the priest is called to a life of obedience to the will of God, obedience even unto death of self. The priest is called to offer his or her life in sacrifice for others. That is not vanity. Lastly, if the priest is another Christ, we look to Christ in communion. Christ gives us his life in the sacrament of his body and blood under the elements of bread and wine. So if the priest is an altar Christus, then the priest is one who is called to the life of Christ. The priest is called to become good bread. The priest is called to be devoured. That is not vanity. The creche, the cross, communion, symbols of the life of Christ, symbols of what it means to be called to the life of Christ, to be another Christ, an altar Christus. The creche, the cross, and communion are anything but symbols of vanity, are they? Lynne, the call to the priesthood is a call by our Lord Jesus to increasing humility. The call to the priesthood is a call by our Lord Jesus to pick up a bigger, heavier cross and to follow him. The call to the priesthood is a call by our Lord Jesus to become good bread which is devoured. Hearing that, many people would say, "Dear Lord, why would anyone want to become a priest?" Well, I think it a mark of a true call to the priesthood. It's seen in a person who really does not want to become a priest, as if that were a goal, an objective, a step up on a ladder of career opportunities. Becoming a priest is not the objective. Wanting to be faithful. Faithful to God's call in one's life is the objective, even if it means becoming a priest, even if it means becoming a bishop. But the same can be said of all Christians, lay or ordained. A call to follow Christ is a call to his royal priesthood, a priesthood shared by all baptized persons. As we say to the newly baptized, "We receive you into the household of God, confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood." Share with us in his eternal priesthood. Every baptized person shares in Christ's priesthood. That means every baptized person, ordained or lay, every baptized person is an altar Christus. In our catechism, in response to the question, what is the ministry of the laity? It says, the ministry of lay persons is to represent Christ, to represent Christ. That is, the ministry of laypersons is to be an altar Christus, another Christ, wherever they may be in the world. The call to all Christians is to the humility of Christ as seen in the creche. The call to all Christians is to the sacrifice of Christ as seen on the cross. The call to all Christians is to the continued giving of one's life to others as seen in communion. Again, if that is the case, one might ask, why would anyone want to do that or be that or live that way? Why would anyone want to become a Christian? Well, again, it's not about becoming a Christian as an objective, a step up into the respectable circles. It's not about becoming a Christian in order to get into heaven. No. It's about being faithful to Jesus, the one we love. Faithful to Jesus, the one who says, where I am, there will be my disciples. Creche. Cross. Communion. For there is but one priest, Jesus Christ. And there is but one priesthood, his. And each of us lay, and each of us ordained, participates in his priesthood by virtue of our baptism into his body. Lynne, in this rite tonight, you will be taking a deeper step into Christ's priesthood. Once a lay priest, soon an ordained priest. Like entering into holy matrimony, it is not done unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes of God. You've been through the process leading up to this evening, and it's a daunting one at that. Many, many years, many, many hours of study and prayer, many, many bishops, all within this diocese. You and I began this journey with Bishop Icahn, and then Bishop Buick, and then Bishop Fole, and then Bishop High, and then Bishop Mayer. And tonight, Bishop Halsey was thrilled to be your ordained bishop. In a moment, Bishop Halsey will ask you one last time if you believe you are truly called by God and Christ's church to this particular expression of Christ's priesthood. I believe you are so called. We who are gathered here this evening all believe you are so called. We believe you are faithful enough to say once again to that call, a yes. A yes which doesn't end tonight. A yes which will continue every day from this day until the end of your day. And in those days and years to come, as you live into your life as an ordained altar Christus, as you humble yourself, as you shoulder your cross, as you become good bread, remember this, you are not alone. We are all, one way or another, in that priesthood with you. And most importantly, he is with you too. Sacerdos, altar, priestess. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.